What we have here is a guest that is a national speaker and a trainer. He helps individuals and companies grow their business through marketing. I used the word yesterday or the day before, guerrilla marketer, because this guy is not like any kind of boring college marketing stuff that you've heard. He's all about technology and automation and things like that, but this is a whole different level. So you got to get a piece of this. But he does travel the nation. He trains thousands on how to make more money. He's an expert on the real estate investment side of things too, as well as the lending side. He's got thousands of students that are closing deals, okay, guys, in the millions, all right, by using his techniques, real estate market, marketing, branding, and in the healthcare space too. So he's also involved in software, and I'm just going to turn it over to this guy. He's an incredible guy. Let me welcome to the Real Estate Wholesalers Club, Mr. Jason Palliser. Hey, welcome, sir.
Hey, how are you? My wife's over there clapping. My wife's over there working on our Airbnb stuff. So if everybody here today is ready to roll, then just hit me with any questions, and I'll tell you a little bit about what we do. But it's time for some, we've been joking around, myself and my wife, it's time for pandemic profits.
Yeah, I wish I could hit the button and roll the music, because it sounds like an incredible segment we're about to break into. What is going on with the pandemic and stuff? I mean, what are you seeing here? What's going to happen to things?
So what I'll say, and as I cough when you say pandemic, influenza B, I got tested since I do travel and speak and train people, and got the green light 48 hours ago that all I have is a horrible cold. So what do we do right now? So myself and my wife, Jess, our team, we have a team in St. Louis. That's where I'm personally originally from. So that's always going to be our main city. But we do this at any given time in 130, 140 cities across America for big companies to basically beat everybody to stuff. So we had a phone call with a lot of those entities that are needing 1,000 homes, 1,500 homes, that we've put together two-day blueprints for, because that's what we do. We started doing it for individuals again. But in this environment, the phone call that we had just centered around a few things. It started with, hey, we're at an uncertain environment right now. That breeds a couple things. One thing it breeds is that people are scared to set appointments, right? So what we do is we talked about being the most user-friendly, meaning this. If you don't have it set up yet to where you can sign contracts via DocuSign, stuff like that, while you guys are all quarantined at home and trying to set up your business and poise it to do more deals, one simple thing that you can do as a smart CEO of your business or business owner is set it up to where you can electronically send contracts back and forth, right?
Yeah.
Second thing you can do is when you're talking to a homeowner, you know, you're using your marketing efforts to get homeowners that might want to sell to raise their hand, right? So what you want to do is let them know that it's okay. Hey, if you want, we can just do a video tour of your house. We buy lots of properties. Mm-hmm. So frame it right. So if you're listening right at home, it's all about, there's nothing stopping you from getting more appointments and doing your marketing to get homeowners to raise their hand. It's just that you have to operate differently. So what you want to do is say, hey, if you can just use your phone to go around the house, we buy lots of properties. So we're 100% comfortable on our end, just seeing your house, writing a contract and still looking to press forward and be a solution for you. So that's another thing that you can do.
Yeah.
Here's a big one. And this actually closed us. I shouldn't say close. It actually got us a deal that we're going to close out here in the future. We got three contracts this week, but one thing we did was we told them, like, look, we can buy it. So if you guys are, and gals at home are listening, we frame it like this. Hey, look, thanks for talking to us or whatever. We're certainly interested in your house, but right now in this environment, we don't buy every property. We try and help everyone we talk to. So whether we come do an appointment with you or not, our team's already out in the marketplace daily. So yeah, if you need anything, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, if you need anything, if you need groceries, we'll drop them off for you. If you need something delivered or picked up, we'll grab it for you. We're already out talking to other homeowners and writing contracts and helping them come to solutions. So yeah. This isn't about us buying a house. We can do that any old time. But if there's anything you need help on, we're already out. We're already in our cars going on appointments. What can we help you with? And we had a homeowner that said, hey, I need to deliver something to the post office, but I don't want to leave the house. So we did that for them. Consequently, we did a 2-minute walk through their house, told them we would crunch numbers and send them an electronic and we got that deal. So being user friendly in today's environment is a smart move. And the last thing I'll say on it is, folks, sharpen your knife, because right now with all this uncertainty, people not working, people are going to struggle. You can be a solution for them for the next 6 months, 12 months, 18 months. You're going to see a wave of homeowners raising their hand. Right now is one of the best times ever to put your foot on the gas as far as marketing goes.
Yeah. Does that not echo what you've heard me say, guys, that it's only getting better from here if you're a smart wholesaler or investor? Like, really, for real, I'm busy. He said he just got 3 deals under contract this week. Yeah. What's your excuse, guys? For real, Corona?
Yeah, as I cough. I have 0 lung capacity right now. My wife's over there laughing at me.
That's all right. Well, that's why we're doing this digitally, because we're all scared of you a little bit.
So is my wife. I just flew back home. I just flew back home down to Florida from St. Louis. And I know there was a level of uncertainty as I was flying back, because she knew I had the cough. That's why I stayed in St. Louis for an extra. It took 8 days, folks, for me to get my test result back. It was insane.
Whoa. 8 days. Wow.
Yeah,
man. So you had to sit in the drive-through a real long time then. It was a drive-through test thing, and you were there for 8 days.
Yeah, I drove. I was in and out on that. That's what I did. I did a drive-through. So
really?
I drove through. They shoved that thing up my nose, that cotton swab, and then yeah. I was gone in 60 seconds.
Wow, wow, man.
Did it but hurt? Yeah, so, no, it didn't hurt. Everybody, I was like, what is everybody talking about?
Yeah,
didn't hurt. So if you're worried, go get a test. But I'll say to what you said earlier, now's the time. Absolutely is the time. My wife's over there literally just researching. And she runs our entire Airbnb business. It took a hit because people are canceling. But some of the skills that she has and some of the promos she ran got rebooking. So what do we lose, baby? 8 grand? But we gained back 4 or 5? Something like that? Yeah, so at first it sucked, and I had to coax her off the bridge because she was about to jump. And but then she just started doing what she does well and did all of her promos. And then we're filling the properties back up with people that say, "Screw this! If I'm going to be quarantined, I want to be quarantined in a better place." Right?
Well, let's just do this interview with her, man, because I think she sounds smarter.
She's about, I would say, at least 7 times smarter. Hey, babe, come here. You can at least say hi. Come here, baby. Folks, I couldn't agree with Justin more. Now is the time to put your foot on the gas, and everybody's home. Everyone's home right now. You can get a hold of them. Okay, so here's the smartest one.
Say hi.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
Good. How are you guys doing?
Doing pretty good.
She's an Airbnb monster.
Yeah. You know, you have to be, for him, knowing him a little bit that I do, you've got to be a super strong woman to keep him in line, right?
Yeah, to say the
least. That's that's actually a full-time job.
Yep, it is. I have many of them.
But folks, you can hit up Jess if you want some Airbnb knowledge. She's got a whole system in place to run it like a well-oiled machine. Where would you like them to go?
Yeah.
Website?
Yeah, Airbnbinvest.com.
Airbnbinvest.com. So say bye, babe.
Cool.
Bye, guys.
Yeah. Yeah. So,
go to Airbnbinvest.com, and you can get some information on that. She has it down to a science, all the way on identifying a property and knowing with the highest degree of certainty that it's the right choice. It's almost like unfair. And then literally once you get a property, fill it the right way. And then how do you market it to SEO on all these vacation rental websites?
Yeah.
Every time I try and put my foot in her sandbox, she chops it off.
Yeah. man, I'm not doing any of the Airbnb stuff, but I know a few guys that are. And but to me, when I hear them talk about it, it sounds like the funnest, coolest thing ever to me. I'd love to get involved in it somehow. So I'm going to go to her site and check it out myself.
Well, here, I'll just give everyone here perspective real fast. And I'll say this fast and we can move on to some lead generation stuff. But the reason why is it's my favorite exit strategy at this point. We do 80% wholesale, 10% flips, 10% Airbnb, but those numbers are going to shift. And here's what I mean by that. Okay. We have a house in St. Louis where we used to live. So we kept it instead of selling it. And my wife got it all ready to go. We could probably make 20 grand a year in rent if she just rented out traditionally. Mm-hmm. In 12 months, we made 71 grand.
Wow.
71 grand. That's like four times the rent.
Yeah.
Three and a half times the rent. Like, it's insane.
Like on a daily basis too, right? Pretty much.
What do you mean?
Like it's coming in every day, right? Money instead of like once a month or.
Yeah, correct. It just comes in when they stay. So again, Jess has it down to a science. She's got tools and weapons for everybody to like, you pick a zip code you want, Justin. And okay, I'm going to Airbnb in this zip code. And she goes through and she will give you the resources to go in that zip code, match the exact bed count, see how many other ones are similar to that, tells you the average nightly rate and what's the percentage per month that it's rented out. Meaning this, hey, it's rented out for 70% of the month. The average nightly rate is 150. So then you can just multiply that out and go, oh my God, it's going to be like three times the rent. And that house that you were on the fence about, you're like, man, it's 10 grand too high. All of a sudden you're like, well, shit, I pay 30 grand extra for it now.
Right.
Because it's going to cash flow like a, I'm trying not to cuss. It's going to cash flow like a freaking monster. And
go ahead and say it, man. Wow. It's okay.
Like a fucking monster. He's over there smiling.
That's great. Yeah.
It makes my nipples hard.
That's why I say it sounds like fun. Yeah. Because it makes your nipples hard. That's great.
Yeah. Jess just said, hey, the money comes rolling in. They book. So within 24 hours of their stay or whatever. So money keeps flowing in per stay. It's freaking amazing.
Yeah. So you don't have to wait till the first. You get it. You could literally like have it every day, even money coming in off that.
Yeah. Right? Money comes in and then we go celebrate usually with margaritas.
Yeah, that sounds great. That sounds good. Yeah, out by the pool or whatever, huh?
Uh-huh, yeah, right on. Oh, yeah.
All right, yeah. Hey, guys, there you go. There's a taste. There's a taste of the flavor, all right?
Yeah. So lead generation, what does everybody want to know?
Well, we want to know how to be expert guerrilla marketers. I mean, like, how do we really... you know, what most of us are doing is text blasting or maybe even ringless voicemail. But there are people and that might work great for a large geography that you want to, you know, go into, but you like, here's the thing. Everybody knows here on this podcast probably heard my story and they know that I've said I've done a few hundred deals in my career, but this guy, all right, Jason has done more deals in my own market than I have. And he doesn't even live here. Okay.
Yeah.
So tell us about how you do it. I mean, how do you do it?
Okay. Yeah. So laying the framework for everybody. I'll start by saying, and you were right. Like, I don't know if you have a crystal ball, you're clairvoyant, you just see the future, but my wife is definitely smarter than me. So I always tell everybody, I am no smarter than anybody else. But when you're a lead generation expert labeled by other people because you do it and it produces results, what happened is this, is that about 16 and a half years ago, I had my first hedge fund, meaning people with millions of dollars that say, hey, we're going to use a portion of our money to invest in a market and diversify with rental houses. So I'm no smarter than anybody else. But if you fast forward 16 years and working with tons of hedge funds that need a 1,000 homes in 72 months, that's real pressure, right?
Yeah.
So we put together the off-market blueprint, the two-day blueprint, to get to everything first, 30 different ways. So I'm no smarter than anybody else, but if you give me big budgets, Justin, I pay attention. I figure it out.
Yeah, right.
So I'll say this, and then I'll give you some other techniques that maybe you're not aware of, okay?
Yeah.
Let me guess, folks. You've had training, okay? You've had training. You go, to Facebook gurus, okay? You YouTube it, yeah. And they say, hey, mail to high equity absentee owners. Hey, use the Freedom of Information Act to get water disconnects and code violations.
Right.
Hey, and here's our training. Mail, postcard, letter, postcard, and then be consistent. And they charge you for that shit. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
And then they say, we're sophisticated. We do voicemail drops and text message blasts. And here, I agree with everybody that says that 100%. You should do that, but just maybe. And here's where on a Saturday, you guys can be nimble and make an immediate shift. I'll give you a few things here. Just maybe there might be a better process. Meaning this, I always tell everybody, you don't have a lead generation problem. You have a process problem that can be solved. In 138 cities, 34,000 homes acquired over 16 and a half years. The data tells us the truth. So what we do is we test 100 variations of one postcard.
Wow.
Concurrently in 138 cities. So imagine a world where you can literally know what wins. So here's an example for everybody. Here's one wrinkle that you can add to your process you already have that'll actually reduce your budget and increase your output. So here we go. So what we do, and we do a two-day blueprint build out, we build out operational mind maps. This isn't note-taking and guru chapter one crap. We actually walk you through systems and process on how you do this. So when good leads come in, Justin, here's what we do. First thing we do is we add to your protocol. We add to your process, meaning now you're doing it like a machine. Lead comes in. Okay, I do this. Here's one of them. So write this down, mm-hmm. everybody.
Right.
So one thing that we do in the blueprint is we have you go to Office Max, mm-hmm. and ask them if they can make an ink stamp for you the size of a Post-it note. When they say yes, you go buy every Post-it note in the store because you're going to turn them into fucking bombs. Okay. And here's what you're going to put on it. You're going to put on there, hey, call me about your neighbor. Now, Justin, when you get leads coming in, you or somebody, and we teach you how to do that logistically because we handle the logistics for these big companies. So when we help you, we help you with the logistics of making sure this is executed right. So you're going to actually tag those doors of those leads you have with a note that says, hey, call me about your neighbor. Now, Justin, when you get home and there's a note on your door, by the way, that technique costs 1/10 of 1 cent.
Yeah.
1/10, not even a penny. So when you get home and there's a note on your door that says, hey, call me about your neighbor, what do you do, Justin?
What has that some bitch been up to now? I better find out.
Correct. You're like, what fucking neighbor is talking about?
Right.
I know it's Sally. I know it's Sally to put down that son of a. And
then
you call, and here's what we do. And by the way, we've tested 200 variations of door tags inside our two-day blueprint. When we do the build out, we have two that you're going to use that we know win by a mile. But here's where we teach you technique. It isn't just try this technique. It's now we teach you the logistics. So when they call, I'm like, hey, Justin, I put that on two houses. Could you, which address? So I know which one I'm talking about. And they'll go 123 Candy Lane. Now I know what lead it is. And then I simply say, hey, Justin, look, I was talking to somebody two streets over about a property, and they said that your street might be a good street to talk to homeowners about potentially buying their house just the way it sits. So really appreciate you calling me back. Whether you want to sell now or 10 years from now, I would love 10 minutes to see it and literally leave you with the contract standing offer. So I thank you so much I'm interested in your house. That's why I tagged your door. Thanks for calling me back.
Wow. Right to the point.
And guess what? I've officially don't lose sight of this, folks. I've officially removed them from my marketing budget.
Yeah.
They called me. I won the, here's why. Text message, postcard, all this other stuff that they ignore, because a lot of them ignore it. You guys all know that. That's why you do a bunch of that, right?
Yeah.
It's a disruptor. It's very hard for them. Think about this. They have your marketing in their hand. They pull it off the door. You're winning the game. You're in their hand. And it's going to consume them mentally until they call because they wonder what's going on with the neighbor. That's a way to win the game.
Yeah.
Okay. And then we flip them, just like I told you, into an appointment.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And you make the offer right then and there.
Oh yeah. If they want an offer on the phone, we absolutely give them an offer on the phone.
Or at the appointment. Yeah. Either way, right?
Yeah, correct. Yeah, either way. Another thing that we do is
let me say that too. www.2dayblueprint.com.
Mm-hmm.
And it's
schedule a call and talk to us. Yeah.
It's the number two. Okay. So www.2dayblueprint.com. Go over there, guys, and check it out. And you know, I don't know what all he has there. Well, I'll check it out too. If he's got something you can buy, I have looked into this a little, okay? And everyone, and I mean everyone that I have ever heard of or read of that has gotten his content, purchased it, 100% satisfaction. I'm serious.
I appreciate that. Well, here, yeah. It's this simple, folks. I tell everybody, if you could find one person that says that we didn't over-deliver and that we didn't help ongoing like we promised to do without some big mentorship fee, because that's not who we are, then we'll do your two-day blueprint build out for half, but you'll never find it. If you want to make your life easy, Justin, you said you looked into it. So you can just go to Jason Palliser on Facebook and click on my cover photo, not my profile picture, but my cover photo.
Yeah.
It's a picture of me teaching. And I put in the picture. I said, hey, I know people are interested in the blueprint. So I've tagged a bunch of our clients. I'm sure they'll start commenting on what we did for them. And folks, you know that you can click on their name. So read all the comments, click on any one of their names and ask them directly, independent of me and me or my wife, and ask them what they feel about the blueprint.
Yeah.
Exactly. I have one guy, Anthony, he's like, I talked to 100 people just to find a chink in your armor, and I couldn't.
Yeah, yeah. I've heard another gentleman. I think he's even in the room. He said he did that. Went through and literally called like over 30 people that have done your program, and every one of them is just like, "Do it now, go."
Who is it? Who's in the room?
Thomas, where are you?
Thomas. Hey, Thomas, put a comment in there. Thomas, you're right. Thomas talked to like 30 people because I was getting screenshots from my clients. They're like, hey, Thomas talked to me about what did you think about the blueprint? And then Thomas obviously just did the blueprint. He got it. So I'm sure he can comment on what we did. And it's just simple, folks. People teach the same five techniques. Imagine where we suffocate a city 30 plus ways. Most people only know five or six techniques.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right. The tax delinquent that we'll teach you, we are light years ahead of what anybody else does.
Can you give us a snippet
of the tax delinquent?
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay. This is you really want Thomas is probably typing frantically. No, don't do it.
why is that?
Well, it's now, good though.
Now you have to, because you've built it up too much.
Hey, Thomas.
What's up?
Hey,
Thomas is also corona free. He's been tested. Okay.
He's not herpes free. He's corona free.
I have a bad sinus infection though.
So Thomas went through it. So, okay. I'll give everybody that's listening a little bit of I'll give you the gist of the tax delinquent. So Justin, if you're going to send out marketing to somebody that's behind on their taxes, potentially going to lose their house to tax sale or tax lien to tax sale, most you'd probably market the way pretty much every investor in America does, which is,
yeah,
hey, before you lose your house to tax sale, let me put some what?
I don't know. Fill in the blank for me.
Yeah, money in your pocket. That's what everybody.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Right. That's what everybody does. So we've tested out 138 cities over a 6-year period and literally zeroed in on this over probably 110 variations. We actually built out a full-blown tax assistance program. So we don't even talk about buying their house. So they call us. Not only do they call us, we never take a phone call saying, oh, you're just one of those investor flippers, aren't you? Aren't you?
Wow. Yeah.
And it's hard to get information out of them. So we built out a full-blown tax assistance program with questions, approval codes, stuff like that. And here's the fun part. When they call us, they tell us everything. I say, yeah. Hey, look, we're going to talk about your financial situation and about the property and see if we can give you any assistance. So we say, hey, what are your bills a month? And what do you make a month? They'll tell you in 2 seconds flat because they're motivated. They want to know if they can qualify for some assistance. Hey, tell me about your house. What does it need any work? It needs 4 windows, 3 ceiling fans, 2 light covers, and there's a dead shrub on the left side of the house. They're so motivated that they tell you everything so you know how to craft a real solution for them. You ask them their favorite color, they're like, purple.
Yeah.
They freak it to, and then they call in because it's our marketing letter has a tax assistance code on it.
Yeah.
They say reference our tax assistance code TAC424001. Why? Because those numbers sounded good together.
Right.
and it works like a freaking charm. So then we offer them, if they're $5,000 behind, we offer them, our company only offers a maximum contribution of $50 because we don't have unlimited funds.
Yeah.
So they owe $5,000 and it's 50, that really doesn't help. So then we work other solutions for them. We say, hey, we may be able to do a tax loan for you that needs to be repaid with a return on investment in 6 months. If they don't pay you back, then you can work on buying their house. And you tell them, hey, look, if that's not going to help your situation, because they already just told you everything, then we just say, hey, look, somebody's going to steal this from you at tax auction.
Right.
Like you're 2 weeks away. I'm looking at my little crystal ball here. You're 2 weeks away. So, or you're a month away or 2 months away. Somebody's going to steal it and you're going to end up with nothing except tax liens and judgments and no money. Why don't we do this? I know your entire situation. And then we just go into, why don't we just pick a day and time, come by the house and we'll leave you with a standing offer. So at least you have a safeguard.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Destroys the universe. We have one guy in our private 2-day blueprint Facebook group because we help everybody ongoing forever.
Yeah.
Or at least until we die, and then my wife will take over and then our team will take over. But we have one guy, his name's Scott. Thomas may have even talked to him. Scott Jordan, anybody in here can talk to him too. He had on that mailing campaign. Everybody, when you do direct mail, you get a 0.5%, 1%, 1.5% response rate. Getting 40, I know you won't believe me, but ask him, Scott Jordan. Look up Scott Jordan, folks. He had a 40.5% response rate in 6 weeks.
Wow. Wow. That is miraculous.
Because everybody, now, I would tell you on average, we get anywhere from a 7 to 13% response rate. That's like a gazillion percent more than a regular direct mail campaign. Do you see? Yeah, hopefully exactly. Everybody listening can understand that you don't have to have a big budget if you do this right. Now let's go back to, I'm no smarter than anybody else. You give me big budgets by several companies in multiple cities and I get to test everything. I pay attention. I get to tweak it, test it and see what wins so that we can destroy the universe.
Yeah. Yeah. That's incredible, man. You know, it's like right in your face. Like now that you say some of these things, it's like, why have I never thought of some of these things? It's so simplistically beautiful. You know, it's like candy. I love it.
Yeah. I mean, it's not, I'm just typing.
And my guess is that Thomas would have said, no, don't talk about what you were just talking about there. It's because you guys are out there cleaning up and you don't want the competition because these are some killer ideas.
Well, and here's the thing. I always tell everybody this, that letter, think about this, Jessen. That letter has been fine-tuned over 6.5 years.
Yeah.
So, of course, myself or my wife can help you push people in the right direction, which is what you're here to do. But imagine when we're done here, you have to sit down and figure out the letter. It needs to be professional.
Mm-hmm.
You need to buy a domain name like Tax Care Oklahoma or Tax Care Tucson, right? Mm-hmm. What are you going to put on that website? What's your letter going to look like? What's the approval code? What's the turnaround time? How do we do? What questions do you ask? Yeah. Those are called logistics. So imagine a world where you can just literally have all that done and just press your foot on the gas the moment you're done with the blueprint, because we have the letter done. We have the postcard done. Our team's waiting for your questions post blueprint. Hey, I'm just getting ready to put up my website. I bought my tax care domain name. Our team will do that for you in 30 minutes, free of charge.
Wow.
You're on our team. Yeah. You're on our team permanently. It's permanent mentorship. Thomas, who's here listening this morning, he's been on the inside of our Blueprint Assassins and our Blueprint family for a few months now. He could probably attest to this. He could put a comment in if he wanted to, but he's probably seen, since he's been in, 500 questions asked by our investors that come onto our team, and 500 questions answered just in the couple months that he's been in. And so whatever question you have, we've done this thousands of times. Our team does a Zoom. They'll jump on the call with you. We'll log into your tracking system that we build for you and fine tune and tweak your stuff. You're on our team.
Yeah. Let me put this in perspective, guys, real quick. Let me put it in perspective. Cause when you hear somebody say, somebody that's done thousands of deals, okay, that's like some abstract thought, like I'm going to go to the moon and it's 800, whatever space miles. Okay. I don't know what that means. I have no point of reference for it, but let me give you a point of reference. In my market, okay, just in my local market, I think the number that you've done here is about 1600 in Kansas City.
Yeah, Kansas City, 1600 plus houses, yeah.
Alone, just in my market. But he was not just in my market, okay? All right, so that's the perspective for you.
Yeah, in your market, we trained a guy named Blake Bolin. He came to our Blueprint. He was doing real estate with his dad. His dad's kind of a big wig. But his dad was just old school, the MLS stuff. He had plenty of money, but Blake was like, man, there's a better way to do this to get better deals. So his dad told him, no, he came to a Blueprint, and now he's torching. I mean, he's torching Kansas right now. Wow. And his name's Blake Bolin, B-O-L-E-N, if anybody wants to talk to him.
Yeah.
In your market.
I do want to talk to him.
Yeah. Here, I'll type it out so anybody can talk to him personally. We want people to connect with each other. And that's what we do with the Blueprint. People tell us, hey, Jason, have you trained other people in my market? I don't want it saturated. And I always tell people, here's what I say to that. And I hope this helps everybody today and moving forward. Oh yeah, I spelled Blake wrong. Sorry, folks. I type with just two fingers. It's one of my handicaps. So if we were worried about competition, our primary market is St. Louis. Jess and I would never have trained. We've trained 22 investment assassins, Blueprint Assassins in St. Louis. And if we teach you 30 ways to suffocate a city, not just three or four, okay? To think that you're going to run into another Blueprint client in the same zip code at the same time, running the same technique for the same reason, is almost negligible. I already know with certainty, right? And to echo that and then move on, here's what I would say to that. You want another Blueprint assassin in your city because you are going to go on vacation. You are going to be out of town.
Yeah.
When we help you turn on the machine that we build for you, and you suffocate a city 30 ways, not just two or three techniques, you're going to get in front of more leads than you could possibly dream of. And from time to time, when you're busy, you want another Blueprint assassin that knows how to do a seller waltz. Cause on day two of the Blueprint, we teach you negotiations, and you want them to be able to do the Blueprint seller waltz, just like you do it. So now you can leave town and there's no drop off. Vice versa. Blake leaves town. Now he knows that Justin knows exactly how to do the seller waltz. Blake just sends a text to Justin. Hey, I got three appointments this week. Can you go on and we'll find a way to make money together? That's how the real game works.
Yeah. Suffocate a city. Guys, have you ever heard anybody talk like that before with marketing? Like you've heard me talk about marketing where you throw a line in the water. Okay. He's talking about suffocating a city. Like, this is a whole other concept, and I'm trying to wrap my mind around some of it too. I'm growing. He's stretching me this morning a little bit too. So, or maybe a whole lot.
But if I can be frank, I mean,
yeah.
And people that will listen to this will know it. Like, half of the gurus, you folks listening follow on Facebook have sat on our couch.
Yeah.
So, yeah. People that I've got my tentacles on, Joe McCall. I mean, I could start everybody with names, but some of them make me sign NDAs. Some people that worked at big organizations, that I know you guys have all listened to their webinars or had their beginner level training. Like, you imagine this, a hedge fund hires us to do 1,000 homes in Houston in 72 months.
Has other coaches asked you to sign NDAs?
Yep.
What the fuck?
I know, people listening right now. So individual investors, for 10 years, I wouldn't do this for individual investors because I owned a software company for real estate called REI Black Book, but I sold. So I don't have 200 emails a day anymore. Right.
Yeah.
So about 3.5 years ago, I go, okay, anybody wants to do an off-market blueprint like I do for hedge funds? Okay, let's do it. But some of these coaches have had assigned NDAs. So imagine a world if you're an investor listening right now, you're like, you know what? I want to suffocate my city 30 different ways. And I want to get trained on how to do a seller waltz.
That was another one. I was like, man, see, this is a whole other. Yeah.
Yeah. So, I mean, I've trained 42 acquisitions teams. I've taught negotiations for the state of Illinois. Like in 4 minutes flat on every appointment you go on, we can turn a seller no into a yes 10 separate ways. I just had somebody post the other day, and I think Wholesaling Houses Every Day. It's one of the groups that we run, Wholesaling Houses Every Day. And somebody put in their seller waltz, and then they put fire next to the seller waltz. Or like it works like a charm. But imagine you as an investor being at a blueprint and then looking over at somebody from Clever Investor or whatever. I've signed an NDA, so I can't say names and stuff like that. And you're the people that you followed online that you looked up to are sitting on the couch just like you.
Yeah. Yeah. That's interesting. Interesting. Yeah. What an honor to have you here today, man. Thank you for being here. You want to open the floor? Anybody in the Zoom room got questions for Jason this morning? Now's your chance, guys. Like I posted in the group yesterday, I think it was it. If you'd like to spend a few minutes and ask a question of an expert guerrilla marketer, here's your shot. Okay. Don't clam up now.
Yeah. If anybody's got a question, you can ask me. I mean, when we do the build outs and I'll wait for a question or two to come in if anybody has any, but like we're doing an online, we got the pandemic, right? I had an April blueprint where people were flying to Florida for 2 days to do a 2-day blueprint, but we're actually just going to do a live stream of it. So if you schedule a call at 2-day blueprint, the number 2dayblueprint.com, myself and my wife will be notified, and then we'll jump on the phone and get you all the info. But when we do your build out, leads coming in 30 different ways, flow straight into a system so you don't have to think, because we already have your tracking system. And then the biggest thing that we do is we build out how do we get a response rate for you. So our first 6 levels of attack cost less than $1. So no investor you ever shake hands with, unless we've got a blueprint. Go ahead.
I got a question.
Yeah.
Tell me if I'm crazy or not. For Justin's group, is there any way that you can work out like a group pricing? Like say if the price where say like a person can't afford the 2-day blueprint, is there a way that you can work out a price like for Justin's, for the one that's on the call right here, that's on the Zoom call?
Yeah, so if anybody wants to email me, we actually did that because we're live streaming. So we actually have 3 options, okay? So I'm typing in my email, just shoot me an email and say, hey, Jason, is there any creative way? And then I'll send everybody that's interested different options. So we actually just proactively did that and finalized it, I think, Tuesday or Wednesday of this particular week. Because everybody's like, hey, I can't fly, I can't do this and that, and I'd like to get in. So what we'll do is in lieu of what we normally charge, we'll do it cheaper. And then we can just partner on deals until you hit the 10 grand mark. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Yeah. It makes sense. Sorry. I think you got muted. He had some background.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I just thought that I should ask that, you know, for us here in the group, because, you know, some of us may not be able to afford it. So, you know, sure. I kind of asked that question.
Yeah, absolutely. We want to literally Justin, you've spoke to several people about the blueprint. Thomas, who's listening, spoke to 30. We mentioned earlier on this Zoom video call and stuff. everyone we get our hands on, we set them on fire. We set their biz on fire. It's over. Like, imagine any of you listening right now walking into a hedge fund and they say, hey, we have to average 40 homes a month for 60 months. We have to average 32 homes a month for 84 months, whatever the number is.
Wow.
They don't play games. Yeah. They're like, you have to suffocate a city for us. And quite frankly, everyone listening here, just out of those 30 techniques, there's four or five that we start with once we go into lead generation. By the way, this is built on a mind map, folks. This is built on a mind map that won't forget anything. So imagine when we're done, you didn't have to take any notes because we give you the mind map and it lives on your phone as an app and it lives on your computer as an operational map on how we execute each technique. So you don't have to remember anything, right? So that's what these hedge funds want. If I walked in and said chapter one, they would literally laugh at me and throw me out of my face. So we have this down to a science. So when we get our hands on somebody, it's over. Like, some of the techniques, there's easily, everybody listening, there's 20 deals a year that you guys have right now, 20 deals a year that cost $0 that you don't have a process in place to grab those easy 20 deals that are waiting for you. And what we do on that, just to let everybody know, is that websites. So Motovo, Estately, these are real estate websites that you don't go to because you've already taught yourself personally, well, I've gone to Craigslist and it's mostly wholesalers and I've gone to Zillow and for sale by owners and they're just not motivated. And I've gone to, you don't even know what Motovo is. You don't even know what Gebo is, G-E-E-B-O. When we hang up, go to Gebo. We've closed in the last 12 months, four deals off of Gebo. The problem is you don't know when they're coming. You don't know if it's April 10th, June 2nd, right? So, so therefore you don't do it.
Yeah.
But what if I told you that we have protocol in place when we do your blueprint, when we open up the lead generation tab, there's 30 ways. The very first one says online real estate websites. What if we told you that we put a system in place to where you rip through 16 websites in 10 seconds flat on each one every day on purpose, because we have it all set up for you to automatically do this without forgetting. And per calendar year, there's 20 deals that are at the right price and the right zip code for you. No haggling on price. All you have to do is have the protocol in place and it costs you $0.
Oh my gosh.
That's just one of 30 techniques, but you don't go there because you told yourself. You look in the mirror when we're done. Hey, I told myself that on Craigslist it's only wholesalers. That's called bullshit. You just don't know when a good deal in the zip code you want's coming. So therefore you don't ever put anything in place to make sure you don't miss that deal.
Right.
That's silly.
Yeah.
That's insane to me.
Yeah.
So when these hedge funds say, hey, we got to average 30 or 40 homes a month, we don't miss a freaking deal. That one in Houston for 1,000 homes, we hit go. They had 72 months, they hit 1,000. Within 6 months, we're at 384 acquisitions.
Yeah.
Over 60 a month.
Wow. But if you just want to play around with real estate, this shit ain't for you, right? Because this sounds like a real business, you know?
Yeah, this is, well, I always tell everybody this. If you want good info, go somewhere else. If you want a real machine that you wake up, you wake up with clarity on how the day is going to go down. And because we have inside there a tab that we walk you through. Thomas could even message in the comments. And we have a tab called the Perfect Investor Day. Because we kind of know what one looks like in 138 cities. So you can get done what we want you to get done in 2.5 hours. It doesn't take all day to do this, right? You have to do the right things on purpose, though. I see a question. What kind of deals are these wholesale deals creative? So we do all types of deals. We do 80% wholesale, 10% flips, 10% Airbnb. On day two, and we teach you negotiations, seller waltz. We teach you deal partnering with the homeowner. We teach you owner financing and several other techniques that are creative to close deals others can't see. One technique we'll teach you, Thomas could attest to it, who's listening here now. One technique we teach you, you can actually pay 10 grand more than your competition on the deal and still make more money than they do applying that technique. So that means you close more deals.
Yeah.
That means you close more deals and you can pay more than your competition. That's called not fair.
Right. Cheating. Yeah.
Not fair.
Yeah.
So we do all types of deals. We teach you how to do them creatively. Hmm. And here's the fun part. When you're on our blueprint team, here's what we do. Hmm. The first time that you have a partnership deal, Justin, and you haven't done it before, and you're having weird feelings inside, all you have to do is message us in the group, my friend, and say, hey, I got my first partnership deal. Can you help me structure the deal? We will help you structure that deal. Once we do that once or twice for you, you don't need us for that anymore.
Right.
You're not on an island by yourself when we're done. You're literally on our team permanently without us going, hey, now that we trained you, hey, let's charge you an extra 15 grand for mentorship for 12 months. We don't do that bullshit. But we do command this, Justin. If anybody ever needs help with lead generation systems, process, response rate, negotiations, you simply recommend us. So if you can agree to recommend us when people need help, then you're on our team permanently.
Yeah. Wow. That's great. Like a how family.
Many people, yeah. How many people work with you per market? I would tell you we close 8 to 12 deals in our St. Louis market and we have 2 people. So you don't have to have a bunch of human capital to do this, right?
Yeah.
Raid, I think you were on the live stream. I think Raid got our live stream link from last month by accident. So he listened in on some of the blueprint. I hope you enjoy.
How did that happen, Ryan?
Yeah.
I know Ryan, and he's not even computer, like he's not that with it with computers even.
He found a wormhole on the internet.
Hello? That's right. I just I scheduled a call with one of the guys. I spoke to him for about 30 minutes. Then he sent me some emails. That's how I got maybe my contacts there.
Yeah, which is great. I think I messaged him. Like, hey, man, I don't care. Hey, we'll build out your systems and all this other good stuff. Like, fun doing this shit, folks. This investment doesn't have to be hard. Investment doesn't have to be you spending 4 hours a week on Facebook trying to find through all these comment threads one new nugget that you're going to try. But when they only give you 20% of what you should have done,
exactly,
try it, and then you're frustrated. That's bullshit.
Yeah, and it's just fucking upsell after upsell and shit. And you still don't, at the end, you're like, what the fuck do I know now? I mean, really, I still can't connect the dots.
Yeah, so I mean, like I said, on April 25th and 26th is our next one that we're doing a 2-day blueprint from 10 a.m. to 5. We're going to walk you through what we do. And then depending on what option everybody picks, we'll give you the mind map and we'll also build out your tracking and deal flow. But the stuff we do is not fair. We'll show you how to get on the first page of Google. First page of Google.
if somebody, I get the feeling that if somebody just did 2 or 3 of these techniques, it'd be like more than they could handle and a complete turnaround of where the hell they are right now.
Here's what we do. And I'm glad you said that, because I'm a machine and I'm a fucking monster and I forget. Folks, that doesn't mean we teach you when we do this, we're teaching you how to run this organizationally. This isn't just good information and rah, rah, hey, do this and live on the beach. You guys can do whatever the fuck you want when you close a bunch of deals. Okay.
Yeah.
This is like, I have one person like, you fucking jump straight into it. It was grotesque. I'm like, here we go. Like we sit down, once we get go, we're like, we're going to teach you everything. Yeah. So here's what you need to understand. All you need to do is implement 2 or 3. You close more deals. And part of that perfect investor day that I talked about, where we walk you through what we need you to do. We have how many minutes each task to take you. So you have a benchmark. One of them says, clear as day, it says, work on one strategy at a time. I'm saying all these things. My wife's listening in the other room. We've done this together so many times that she could actually complete my sentences.
Yeah. So it's not like drinking out of a fire hydrant.
No, we teach you. If you have a map that doesn't forget anything, the fire hydrant part of your brain goes away because you're like, oh, I don't have to remember shit. I had a guy from Texas. Mm-hmm. Within 5 minutes of us doing the blueprint, he raised his hand. He goes, hey, are we going to get that map? I'm like, yes. With all those notes and everything, step 1, 2, 3, 4 in each technique. Do I have to take notes? No. And he's from Texas. It was 11 a.m. at the Ameristar Casino where we were doing this training. And he goes, can I drink beer? And I go, yes.
Yes.
Because he didn't have to remember shit. He didn't have to take notes.
Can I drink beer?
Why not? And so this isn't you trying to remember stuff. My wife just hit her knee. How's your knee, man?
That's hilarious.
So this is work on one technique at a time. Perspective for everybody. We get about 30 incoming phone calls off of how to get on the first page of Google for free that we'll put in place for you. Our competitors in St. Louis spend $5,000 to $15,000 a month on being on the first page for sell my house fast, St. Louis. And we pay $0. We are the very first unpaid ad right above them. And then we're the next two, number three and number four, right below them for free. And they pay $15,000 a month for that. But that's just words until we put it in perspective for you that you can understand. That's nice that we can do that. And on your end, if you're listening, that would feel good, but I don't give a fuck about that. Here's the byproduct. We get 20 or 30 phone calls a month on the number one website in the world where people have searched for Sell My House Fast St. Louis and call us and we close deals and it costs us $0. And those leads are amazing. They willfully called us. They had choices. But since we're the first and second, the first, third, and fourth one, and then we also are on the right side of the page as well, almost anywhere they click and read, we're there. So we could teach you how to do that. And all the big competitors in your town that you're like, man, I wish I could be like XYZ in my town. They close 10 deals a month, but they spend 20, 30, 40, 50 grand in marketing.
Exactly.
How can I compete with them? We close 8 to 12 deals a month and spend $700 to $2,500 a month.
How do they not have a bad month or two and just fucking go right out of business? Because that much overhead.
Sometimes they've had skinny months. They've had people try and infiltrate our blueprints since they're in our same market. And they're like having drinks. You know, they know my kryptonite. They're like, hey, Jason, here's another Bacardian diet with a lime. Yeah. After three, they're like, hey, could you teach us a little bit of that cellar waltz? I'm like,
right.
I go like this. You ready, folks at home? Let me show you a magic trick. Ready?
Yeah.
No.
It's like when the magician makes the bird appear.
This doesn't have to be hard. This can be a lot of fun. I just told you a technique that you guys could use that costs 0.1 cent. A post-it note on every lead that you get, have somebody tag their doors, says, call me about your neighbor. Mm-hmm. So when they're ignoring postcards and they ignore your voicemails because you're sophisticated and do voicemail drops and text messages, when we put a note on their door, they call. They're like, what fucking neighbor's talking about me? Right. So we just won the game. And now they're not a part of our marketing budget anymore because they already contacted us. We won. We had a lady named Von Treese that came to a blueprint. She came as Chris. We've done three blueprints for Chris. Each time he comes back, he makes more money. So Chris brought her as a guest because he lived in Denver and he was doing it virtually in Atlanta like we taught him. So Von Treese came to the live two-day blueprint. And when I got to the section on, hey, folks, we're going to tag doors. I've tested 200 door tags. These two are the ones you're going to implement. She raised her hand. She goes, Jason's only known me for an hour, so he really doesn't know me from a hole in the wall. But I've been on Chris's team for 60 days. All I do is tag doors, and I've made $25,000 in 60 days off a door tag. She closed three deals. This isn't hard.
Yeah.
It just has to be on purpose.
Yeah. Intentional. With a plan. Yeah. And a process.
Yeah. And while everybody's stuck in their house right now, why would you not learn from us and have our team build out your entire mother effing system that we do for hedge funds? By the way, we charge them $50,000, anywhere from $45,000 to $55,000, depending on number of houses they need for the same blueprint that you guys could get for, depending on what option you choose, $5,000 or $10,000. Or if you just want to watch and take notes until your hands fall off without the map or anything, then we'll do it for $2,500.
Wow.
I don't know what else I could do to make it any easier. Yeah. Here's what's going to happen though. I'll just tell everybody the future. If you just watch and take notes and you'll learn a ton and you'll start closing a lot more deals and you took a bunch of notes when we're done, because we operate out of the map while we're teaching you, you're going to end up just shooting us an email. I'm like, okay, I want the map. Give me that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Is there a screen share on here? I could show the map if you want.
You can screen share. anybody want him to screen share or maybe not? I mean, absolutely share your screen, man. I think it'll let you.
Yeah, I shared on Propelio, the Google hack. Yes, I did.
Yeah, we're getting folks saying yes.
How do I do a screen share? Is there
If you move your cursor down, there'll be a green button there. It says share screen.
Okay, so let me minimize some of this stuff and go to the map.
That's what my brain looks like, half empty and half cluttered.
That's the link on the blueprint map. So here you go. So this is what we build out for hedge funds to run things operationally. So when we go through a two-day blueprint, what we'll be doing on April 25th and 26th is we're going to walk you through non-negotiables. We're going to see all these notes. That's why the guy from Texas, he's like, I guess I don't need to take notes too. I go, if you're going to take better notes than what we did on a plane with nothing better to do, then knock yourself out. So we have the perfect investor day. Lead generation, all the different ways that we do this. Okay. Lead flow, response attack.
Wow.
We walk you through what we do with the leads to win.
Somebody was out there thinking, Jason, they were thinking, oh yeah, I got him now. I'm a screenshot this shit right here. I got the blueprint, but no.
You cheap sons of bitches. Are you kidding me? Come on. Now here's one tip on our lead flow that we do. If you guys listen to me, if you have a difficult lead, it's a good one and it's eating a hole in your soul. You've been text message, phone call, this, that, postcard, letter, and they're simply not responding. And it's a good lead. Put a for sale sign in their yard. Watch how fast they call you. Put a for sale sign in their yard. And then when they call you, hey, are you trying to sell my house? Sir, what are you talking about?
It's dirty.
Hey, what are you talking about?
Somebody said it's dirty.
I saw it in my yard, but you're sale. I'm like, oh my God, what address, sir? You already know the address. You put the sign in the yard. 123 Candy Lane. Sir. Look, I'm super sorry. Somebody on my team put it at the wrong house. Look, I apologize. Are you going to be there after 5 o'clock tonight? Maybe 5:30? Yeah. I completely apologize. Sorry about that. I'll come pick up the sign. Now I have a fucking appointment with them to pick up the sign. And guess what? I'm like, hey, by the way, I'm sorry about that. By the way, what are you doing? Like, what are you doing with this house? I'd be interested whatever you want to sell. So we have nasty shit we do to get them to respond.
Yeah.
So then we go through.
It takes brass balls to sell real estate. Doesn't it?
So then we go through and teach you negotiations on day two. And we walk you through all the things that we do. 4-minute seller waltz. We have every technique down to a science.
Yeah. Wow.
And so literally you don't have to remember anything. And then our team will also build out your lead flow and tracking and Podio, exactly how we do it for the big companies to manage the flow of massive amounts of leads and properties.
Yeah.
And so when we're done, you have the map that won't forget. You'll have a video replay of the blueprint, depending on what you do. You'll have our systems that we built out, and you'll be in our private Facebook group where it's ongoing free mentorship until the day we die. All we ask is if anybody ever needs help, you refer them. You just recommend us. You don't have to tell them to do a blueprint with us. Just recommend us, right? But speaking for all these big companies and TV shows for 20 years, one by one, slowly canceling all those contracts, because now that I don't have REI Black Book Real Estate Automation Software platform anymore, have time to do individual blueprints. This is more fun than going to speak for 10 grand in a weekend for a big company. This is more fun for us to get our hands on individual investors and show them how this shit's done. Now, if I go back over here, you see why the hedge funds hire us? They're like, we need, here's a free tip for you. Don't you want fire and water damage? when it happens, don't you want to be notified? Because those are good leads. So we teach you, we don't teach you try this. We actually teach you the flow of these leads coming in and how they interact with you. So you actually get the appointment. And then on day two, as I said, then we teach you how to close them like monsters. This isn't a fair fight. So this is why the hedge funds hire us, because we build out their operational attack. You'll run your perfect day in 2.5 hours and do it again and again and again and again and again and again and again.
Yeah. Wow. Wow. Yeah, that's brilliance right there. I'm my mind's just like, I'm thinking, you're giving me ideas and thoughts, and I'm trying to not focus on what you're saying, but I'm still caught up on the last thing you said. And
yeah, so this is so imagine a world where consistently over time, because if you peeked into the perfect day I opened up, most of the way down, it says work on one strategy at a time. I know it's human nature when we do a blueprint, you're like, fuck Jason, I want to get 10 of these done in 1 week. No, you won't.
Yeah. Yeah.
It says deliberately work on one at a time. Once that one, you've worked on that one for 4 days and now it's off and running, then you move on to the next one and the next one. Hey, on the third one, man, okay, I'm going to go ahead and do this third one, but I have some questions. You hit us up in the group. I'm not sure what I should do next to execute. You hit us up in the group. We do a Zoom. We share the screen with you, and then we help you get that thing rolling, and now that one's going. And imagine a world where you don't have to spend $3,000 to $5,000 to $10,000 a month to close 6 or 7 deals a month. You could spend $700 to $2,500 like we do every month and destroy our competition that spends $30,000 or $40,000 in marketing a month that right. are the players in your market.
That's crazy. It's crazy. Yeah. Crazy, crazy. How are you? Yeah.
So HomeVestors, Emily, one of their directors of marketing, she does $3 million in direct mail a month. She contacted us for a couple of our techniques.
Wow.
The biggest marketing company for real estate in the United States contacted our organization. And we ultimately didn't come to terms because they wouldn't give me their data. They really wanted to do some of the techniques that we do because we destroy them.
Yeah.
But they wouldn't. I go, even if you lock me in a room in my underwear so you know that I'm not a spy coming to put some software and steal all your leads. And they're like, man, I would love to, but we can't. But we had 6 or 7 franchise owners from HomeVestors come do blueprints with us last year because they said, look, I'm spending $20,000 or $30,000 a month. I heard you're the guy to do this for way cheaper and way more comprehensive. And so we had 7 franchise owners come to us last year and say, get us out of it. All 7 of them, when we were done, told us to our face, myself, my wife, and our team, they're like, we're out. We're putting up our franchise for sale. They just didn't have an alternative machine to get the good off market leads to close deals. So they were relying on HomeVestors, who does a good job, but they spend a shit ton of money, and the franchise owners have to share in that cost per market. And so we just showed them a better way to do it.
Yeah. Yeah. Smart. Yeah. Smarter way to do it. Smarter. Correct. And cheaper.
And cheaper.
And more consistent, I'm betting. Yeah. I see the same guys you're talking about them advertising. I see, you know, I'm driving up and down the highway and there they've got an expensive billboard. I don't know what those do, but these are like old school ideas, you know. The ideas you're presenting today are not old school. They're cutting edge ideas.
Well, there's a couple techniques that will teach you to get in front of leads that cost anywhere from 2.75 cents to 4 cents. Imagine a world for 2.75 cents to 3.5 cents.
You can't even send a fucking text message for that hardly.
And guess what? We can show you without them ever doing a keystroke. You guys have typed keystrokes and searched for shoes before. And then for the next 4 months, shoes show up everywhere on every website you go to, right? I think everybody knows that, right? It's called cooking. What if I told you there's a way to where, let's say you get 600 water disconnects. That's a good motivated lead, but they've never typed in a keystroke in their life. So there's no way that you could possibly find them on the internet and start showing them, hey, I'd like to pay. Do you want to sell your house? And show up in front of them left and right, right? They've never typed in a keystroke in their life. Maybe they don't even have hands. They can't type. So you can't get in front of them. What if I told you that we have techniques without even having a keystroke ever to get in front of them on virtually almost any website that they visit, ESPN.com, Facebook, LinkedIn, wherever they go online, and there you are. Hey, are you interested in selling house for for 2.75 to 3.5 cents? That's fucking unfair.
Yeah, it is. It is.
So imagine before you even drop a text message, imagine before you drop a text message, imagine before you send out your direct mail, which direct mail works. Imagine before you do that, you hit them one, two, three, four, five, six times with your ad. So now they already feel like they know who you are.
Yeah.
And all you spent was 8 cents.
Yeah.
Your response rate goes up, folks. This isn't fucking, if you do this right, this isn't hard and it's not fair to your competition. Yeah. And fuck the budget.
You are in your fucking zone right now, man. Give it to us, dude. Oh, I love this. It is.
This is fun. So when we're done here, enjoy your set. Celebrate tonight. So have a pandemic party, whatever you want. Celebrate knowing that this doesn't have to be hard, right? You're here because you're trying to learn something. You're like, I need to make my business better. That's smart, right?
Yeah.
So this doesn't have to be hard. I always tell everybody, it has to be on purpose.
Right.
Doesn't have to be hard.
Yeah.
If you don't have to spend a bunch of money. We have people come to a blueprint. We do 9 blueprints a year, 10 blueprints a year, and that's it. Sometimes we limit it to 5 clients, up to 15 or 20, and we shut it down. We keep it small because we get granular with it, right? So we don't do a ton. Yeah. But the people we get our hands on, it's over.
Yeah.
Half the people that come that are actually doing deals, like we have people almost every blueprint that are doing 10 to 20 deals a month. The other people in the room are like, why are you here? They're like, to reduce my budget.
Yeah.
We slashed their budgets.
Yeah. Okay. Let me ask you this real quick, because if somebody's out there and they haven't even done their first deal yet, and you're talking about guys using your stuff to do 10, 20 deals a month. Somebody that ain't even done one deal yet. This is good for them too.
Yeah, correct. I would say 75 to 80% of the people that come to us are getting started and said, hey, I want my business set up an infrastructure to run this like a machine daily from square one. Yeah. I'm brand new. And we say, good. And we're going to write your first 5 contracts for you.
I see.
You're going to do your job. We're going to build out your entire machine and system. You follow it to a T. You don't even have to remember. And we're going to write your first 5 contracts for you. Let's go. Mm-hmm. So absolutely. Most of the people that come to us are doing 0 to 3 to 4 deals a month. And they want to get to 5 to 10. And just like I mentioned, the guy, Chris Galacki, blueprint client, he's done 3 blueprints. He goes, I'm coming yearly. He goes, it makes financial sense for me to do that. And he just keeps closing more and more each time he comes, right? Yeah. And if you're brand new, that's probably is that a fair statement, Jess? 75 to 80% of the people that come that are pretty much 0 deals to 3 deals a month. She's yawning and saying yes.
Yeah. questions, guys. Anybody with questions? I don't want to keep Jason here. I don't want to, make him stay longer than he it's an honor to even have him here. Okay. So let's get the questions fired up. Let's do a lightning round. Anybody with questions, you better hit it before we quit it.
What questions do you have? A lot of people ask us, hey, do you have, we've tested over 400 variations of emails. So when you start to message people from real estate websites, we got the exact email to get the appointment. We know which one wins. Same thing with text messages. Same thing. We walk you through live on day 2 of the blueprint. We start making phone calls live in front of you, so you see the flow of what we do.
Yeah.
We send you an objections, a list of objections and how to overcome them. So we have that all built out for you. It's and the one thing I say is this, we teach you, very first thing that we teach you on the blueprint, it says, you're the CEO, master the process, then scale it up. Meaning, you do this well for 30 days. After that, delegate everything. So we live in a world where we want you to know how to do it, how to run your machine, and then delegate to everybody else.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Automate, outsource, all that stuff included in this.
Okay. So Thomas says, talk about the effectiveness of follow-up and the average amount of touches to get a deal. So we're anywhere from 7 to 12 touches to get a deal, meaning phone call, text message, email, letter. And then once we get them on the phone, some will, someone who cares. A lot of people aren't ready to sell at the number you want right now. We're so, Thomas, you could attest, we're so prepared for that. So what a good part of what we teach in the blueprint is follow-up wins. We have follow-up built in that tab that I opened when I shared my screen that said marketing letters and follow-up. We have follow-up built a mile deep. So I would tell everybody that once you have an initial conversation with somebody, if they're not ready to go, that we touch them on average another 7 to 10 times before we consummate and get a deal. If you don't get the deal on the spot, meaning this, and this is perspective, right? Let's turn these concepts that you hear all these gurus online. Let's turn this into real shit. Meaning this.
Yeah.
Hey, follow-up's just a concept, right? Everybody knows how to follow up, but here's where we make it real. We have a guy named Ron Reynolds that we bought a house from on Shoto Avenue in St. Louis. We talked to him in June. He was here on price. We were here. We expected that. So what we did was we threw him in follow-up, which is the engine that we build out for everybody when they do a blueprint. We threw him into follow-up. We hit him about 7 or 8 times. And he finally, on January 28th, called us back and said, hey, is your number still good? And then we got the deal. We made 37.5. So let's make this real. So follow-up is a concept until we turn it into something real. Contacted us in June. He called us back on January 28th. We followed up probably 8 times and made 37.5. So two things. One, would everybody here follow up 8 times to make $37,500? Yes. Now, you know what the time spent on those 8 follow-ups over the next 7-8 months was? 3 minutes. All we did was hit them with a text message or email. Text message or email, one phone call, leaving a voicemail saying, hey, just touching base. If there's anything we can do to help you with the property, because he was an out-of-state owner. He lived in Texas. The house is in St. Louis. If we can help you in any way, just let us know. Just letting you know that we're still interested in the property if you still have it. And we were super nice.
Yeah.
We didn't know he would call us back on January 28th, but we didn't give a fuck.
Right.
He was in our engine. Oh, there's Ron again. Follow-up. Done with Ron. Move on. Like, so would you follow up 8 times and make 37.5 and spend 3 minutes after an initial conversation? Of course you would. So you need to have a machine that's built that way.
Right.
Right?
Wow. Yeah. Incredible. Questions, anyone? Anyone in the Zoom room? If you're not in the Zoom room, you're listening out there on YouTube, Periscope, Facebook, wherever you might be, and you want to get in here, this is your chance. You better make it quick. Go to zoomjustin.com. Password is money. Money. I'm sorry. What were you going to say, Jason?
I'll say, as I'm waiting for maybe one final question, I can give you a technique that we teach. Remember, I said we teach the seller waltz 10 different techniques. Yeah. I'll give everybody a technique that you can use on a seller appointment to get a deal that works like a charm.
Okay. Yeah, let's go.
So we teach you. Hey, every appointment you go on, the seller's going to want 100 grand a year at 80. It's going to happen almost every time. So let's teach you the seller waltz to be prepared for that. When's the next blueprint? I'll come back to that. When's the next blueprint and where? April 25th and 26th. It's 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time to 5 p.m. And we're going to do a live stream on it. All you have to do is just email me and ask for info.
Somebody on YouTube wants to know if they're limited to one city or county, or can they have multiple?
Multiple. So we teach you how to scale this. These hedge funds that I was talking about, the hedge funds, they usually when they hire us to come in and like 1,000 homes in Houston, it's actually 1,000 homes in Houston and San Antonio and a few other places. So our blueprint is built for you with literally one click of a button to duplicate the entire system and start flowing leads into that city now. So yeah, it's scalable. It's scalable with like one click. It's not limited to one city. The closing technique, Here's one technique that we use to win deals that other people just don't simply know how to do. So we tell every homeowner, hey, look, I think we'll be able to come to an agreement together. But even if we don't, we just appreciate the fact that you're not using a realtor to save money. So if we don't come to an agreement today, because I teach you that most of the time you won't, because you need to soften them up a little bit and just be more valuable than everybody else, so that when they are ready, you get the deal. So we tell them, hey, we just appreciate you're not using a realtor to save money. So here's what we'll do. Even if we don't come to an agreement, which I think we can, I'll help you market your home for free to 14 or 15 different real estate websites to try and help you get what you want. All I ask in return for that, Justin, is that if anybody ever needs help, any friend or family member that needs help or just wants to sell a house just the way it sits, you just think of our company first. And a lot of the homeowners are like, sure. And so if they wanted 100 for it and you were at 80, here's what we do. I'm not mad that they want 100 for it. They're just not realistic right now. I'm not mad about it. So we actually market their home for free, and we teach you how to do that in the blueprint, and flag them for follow-up 2 weeks later. See how I didn't give a fuck about getting the deal? I want to be the most valuable to them. So we flag them for follow-up. We call them back 2 weeks later. And what we do is we market it out there for 106. They want 100. We market it for 106. So we call them back and we tell them, hey, just wanted to give you some feedback. We haven't, they said my info wasn't showing up in the chat.
Yeah. You were sending a private message, I think, to someone. You have to switch that little boxy thing.
Sorry. Try to do two things at once. Which is
I put his website on the YouTube chat, guys, also, and on the Facebook chat. So if you want to go there, and also when this is all wrapped up and we're finished, I'll put it in the description, how to contact or how to find him and get where you want to go with Jason. So check back. If you don't see it now, it will be there. And I'm also putting it in there now. So,
okay. And so here's what we do. So we market the home for free, but we market up $5,000 or $6,000. So we'll turn something we didn't even have under contract potentially into a wholesale deal. If we get somebody that's interested, let's say we get three people interested at 106, we go back to the homeowner and say, hey, I talked to my boss. Let's go ahead and do the 100. We walk those three people through and we turn, get them in a bidding war, make $8,000 out of thin air. That's one way too. If no one responds, then we call them back in 2 weeks because we flagged them for follow-up and say, hey, just want to give you feedback. I'm going to go ahead and refresh your ad, but I don't have any phone calls or emails yet. Just want to let you know. And so then I just say, just so you know, we're still interested. And guess what? When they're the gravity in their brain of knowing that there are multiple websites and still nobody wants it, a lot of times we get the deal now. Hmm. Oh, and here's something that you didn't devote any brain space to. If you're listening, clear your head and listen to this right now. But when we follow up with them, they actually answer our call. Right. Not you. They answer our call. You know why? Because we did something for them that we might have a buyer for them. So they answer our call. Hmm. You get that. That's called process. That's called having a better process than your competition. That wins you deals.
Yeah. Wow. Now, how's that for follow-up system, guys?
Not a fair fight.
Yeah. Right. Hey, it's been an honor to have you here today, Jason. I want to, unless you have anything more you'd like to share with us, we can go ahead and wrap up here. I feel like we've already pulled more from you than we paid for. We really appreciate it, man. Lots of value, tons of value. Guys, don't forget, it is 2-day blueprint, not today, number 2-day, 2dayblueprint.com. Go check it out. And then what was the Airbnb thing that you're, what was
Airbnbinvest.com, right? I'll put it in the chat.
Okay. Airbnbinvest.com. And there's also here, he put
what
in there.
Say, baby? Hold on 1 second, Justin. What? She also has a Facebook group too, Airbnb Investment Blueprint, if anybody wants to join.
Okay. Yeah. There you go. Lots of ways to connect. Make sure you do. This is valuable information, guys, whether you're a beginner or whether you've been in the business for a long time. There are things to be gathered here and learned. So
Thank you very much, Jason. And thank you for everything you've shared with us today. It's been remarkable. And maybe we can have you on the show again some other time if you're interested. We'd love that. So.
Oh, I love helping people kick the shit out of their competition. It's fun.
There you go. And I love the terminology. If you want to suffocate your market, right? And then the seller waltz. I mean, these are, man, doesn't it just feel good though? Those are feel good words. And I like them.
Fun.
It is fun. All right, guys, God bless you. Thank you for listening and watching out there in the world, wherever you're watching this. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. We'll see you next week. Okay. All right. Bye, Saturday, 10 a.m. All right. Thank you. Bye-bye, everybody.
See you later.